Hello friends, I am back. My name is Kalpesh and welcome to my YouTube channel Automotive Crux. In this video, I am going to explain how helix bypass fuel pump works. The helix bypass fuel pump is utilized in diesel engine fuel injection system. I am going to discuss its construction, how does it work and its control mechanism. So stay tuned till the end of this video. Let's see the construction of helix bypass fuel pump. The figure shows the construction detail of the helix bypass fuel pump. In the construction, you can observe plunger with the barrel. Here is the plunger. And the cylindrical construction which encompasses the plunger, which is known as a barrel. The helix cut is grooved on the plunger. If you closely observe the construction of the plunger, then you can observe that the helix groove is cut on the surface of the plunger. This is the helix cut. Fuel supply port. The cylindrical barrel has a port. Here is the fuel supply port. And likewise, it has fuel delivery port. Fuel delivery port, it is located here at the top of the assembly. The fuel is delivered with the help of this fuel delivery port through this channel and it will go up to the fuel injectors. This fuel delivery port, it is a spring-loaded ball valve which is actuated with the help of fuel pressure. In the construction, you can observe the spill control port. So this is the fuel spill port. And apart from this assembly, we have a control rack. This is the control rack, you can say. It helps us to meter and control the fuel supply to the engine. The complete actuation of this assembly, the complete actuation of this plunger, it is actuated with the help of cam at bottom side. The camshaft, it gains power and motion from the crankshaft of the engine. Working of the helix bypass fuel pump. The complete working of this pump, it depends on the effective stroke of the plunger and the actuation of different ports which we have seen in the earlier slide. In the first figure, here you can consider it is the intake stroke. As I said, the movement of the plunger, it is completely controlled with the help of camshaft which is powered with the help of crankshaft of the engine. So in this first figure, we are assuming that the plunger, it is going the downward side. And when it uncovers the intake port, the fuel from the storage tank and the fuel supply line, it flows inside the barrel. This will continue till the plunger will reach up to the bottommost position at certain level. In the next figure, when plunger starts movement towards the upward direction, first it covers the intake port. So fuel supply stops and simultaneously it stops the spill port valve too. Now with the help of further movement of the piston, you can observe in the third figure, in this figure, with the help of the further movement of the piston towards the upward side, it builds the pressure inside the fuel which is inside the barrel. Due to that pressure, this spring-loaded ball valve, it lifts from its position and the pressurized fuel, it goes to the fuel injector with the help of this fuel delivery port. This will continue with the piston's movement towards the upward side. While the helix groove cut, it comes in line with the spill port valve during this upward movement. At this position of the plunger, the spill port valve, it is now in uncovered position. So the fuel which is left inside the barrel, it starts flowing from through this groove to the from this groove to the spill pot valve, and it goes back to the fuel storage. So it releases the pressure inside the barrel, and as the pressure releases due to the spring force of the spring loaded fuel supply pot, it will sit on its original position and closes this passage. So the fuel supply stops. This is the complete working of the helix bypass fuel pump. I would like to repeat again, while plunger starts in downward direction, the intake of fuel will start. Fuel comes into the barrel. When piston starts movement on the upward side, first it stops the fuel intake, then it stops the spill control valve, and then it try to build the fuel pressure, which must be higher than the spring force. With the help of that pressure, it will lift the spring loaded ball valve in the delivery pot, and the fuel is supplied to the fuel injectors. At the end, when the helix groove cut, it comes in inline position with the spill control pot, this pressure releases as the fuel starts flowing from the barrel to the spill pot valve, and it goes to the fuel storage tank, and due to that release in pressure, the spring loaded delivery pot, it will close automatically. Now let's discuss the control mechanism of helix bypass fuel pump. We are all aware with the different operating condition of the engine running at idle, engine running at part load, and engine running at full load condition. At every single position, engine demands different quantity of fuel every time. So compulsory we require some control mechanism which can control and meter the fuel supply to the engine. So here we have a rack and the sector gear mechanism. In this figure I have shown three different situation of the engine when engine demands different quantity of fuel. First is the no delivery, second is the partial delivery, or you can say part loading condition, and the maximum delivery, that means you can consider the full loading condition. In the first figure you can observe that the helix groove position, it is at this point, and the remaining working it will remain same. I have explained in the previous slide. Considering the change in load or considering the different operating condition, if you are considering the partial part load condition, then the rack will move with the help of governing mechanism, and as the rack will create a linear movement, the sector gear, it will rotate, and this sector gear will also rotate the plunger inside the barrel. So now the position of this helix cut, it will change from this position to this position, and due to this, the change in the helix groove position, the fuel supplied, here there is no fuel supply. At this position, when this helix groove cut, it will come in line with this spill pot, spill control pot. Till this point, this plunger will continue to supply the fuel to the injectors. So this much amount of fuel will be supplied in this case. If you are considering the maximum delivery, or you can say full load condition, you can consider the idle condition or the sudden acceleration condition. In this case, the engine demands the maximum fuel. So again, according to the loading condition of vehicle, governing mechanism, it will move the rack, and accordingly this sector gear, it will rotate, and this will ultimately rotates the plunger inside the barrel. So compared to this, in the last case, this helix groove cut, it comes in line later as compared to the earlier situation. So the total amount of fuel supplied, it will be quite higher as compared to the part loading condition, or you can say no delivery. So here this arrow, it indicates the
here this arrow, it indicates the fuel supplied time. So this is what about the control mechanism. Okay, depends on the speed and the loading condition, our governors, it will move the rack, and this rack ultimately moves the sector gear, and it will rotate the plunger inside the barrel. Ultimately it position the helix groove cut inside the barrel, and it will meter and time the fuel supply to the engine. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe this channel, and don't forget to share with your friends too, they will get benefited. Thank you so much.